We have seen that the velocity in radial flow may blow up at r equals zero. This is not some mathematical singularity. The problem comes from the underlying physics, constant flux due to incompressible flow. Now, what about the pressure? Is there a problem in r equals zero too? Well, yes, there is, as you will see in this video, which means that you also need to be very careful in solving your pressure equation. So, what's going on with the pressure? Let's take the easiest case. So, incompressible radial flow, again, pressure. So, divergent equals v equals zero for the incompressible flow. And let's just take for the velocity Darcy's law. So, v is proportional to the gradient of pressure, and take the prefactor of mobility equal to some constant. Then, suppose our flow is just in the radial direction, so our problem is fully radially symmetric, which means that the pressure only depends on r and not on z or theta. So p is p as function of r. That means that our gradient of p only has a component in the r hat direction. So gradient of p equals dp dr in the r hat direction. Now, then we can solve for pressure, because we also know from a previous video that v is a constant over r in the r hat direction due to the incompressible flow. And then we can use Darcy's law. We have here the c over r for v. For the gradient of p, we have dp dr, and the scale of mu is some constant. So combining this, we have that dp dr equals some other constant divided by r. We don't care too much about this c1 now, we just want to look at the behavior of the pressure, not at the prefactor. Now we can solve this equation, we can just integrate with respect to r, and we find our pressure p of r equals a constant times the logarithm of r plus some other constant. Well, this other constant, c2, is always there, because you always can gauge your pressure, so you could always add some constant, so that's natural. We do have a problem, though, with this other term, because the logarithm will blow up both as r equals 0 and r equals infinity. Well, singularity in infinity was always there, but now we also have a problem with our pressure at r equals 0. So, where's that coming from? Well, actually, it's a general feature of the Laplace equation in radial 2D flow. So, what's the Laplace equation? Laplace phi equals zero. If you have a radial problem fully radially symmetric, so only r dependent, then the Laplace operator reduces to this equation over here. And when you solve it, you can first multiply by r, so you get rid of this one. Integrate once, and you see that this r times d phi dr is some constant, c1 over here, divide by r, d phi dr equals constant over r, and integrate once more, you see phi equals constant times the ln of r plus another constant. So in fact, you see this Laplace equation is used much more often, so this logarithmic singularity is actually an inherent property of the Laplace equation in radial flow in 2D. And notice our pressure also satisfies this Laplace equation, because what did we have? Divergence of V equals some constant times the divergence of the gradient of the pressure, but the divergence of a gradient is just the Laplacian of P. And because we have incompressible flow, divergence of V equals zero, so gradient of P equals zero. So our pressure satisfies the Laplace equation, so that means that because we have radial flow, our pressure will behave like the logarithm of r. This is no problem, it occurs much more often, but you just have to know that you have to be careful both at r equals zero, which is new, and r equals infinity, especially if you are starting to do numerics.